Right now, as we promised you, standing by, courtesy of TSN in Canada, yes, there he is, the hitman, Bret Hart. Hello, Bret, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Fantastic. First of all, congratulations on unquestionably one of the greatest wrestling matches in World Wrestling Federation history that occurred at SummerSlam. I know the outcome wasn't exactly to your liking. Nonetheless, the hitman is still the hitman, with one exception. Seems as though Papa Shango is hot on your trail, so to speak. How do you react to that?
Well, you know, Sam, I'm really proud of the way I conducted myself over Wembley. It was a tough match, and I think it was a match that could have gone either way. It could have gone one way or the other. But I do know one thing. Papa Shango and this curse, this supposed curse, I don't believe in the boogeyman. The boogeyman had nothing to do with it. I'm enough of a man to know that I lost in Wembley to a better man that night. But as far as Papa Shango goes, he didn't have anything
to do
with it.
Now, wait a minute, Hitman. I got a question for you. Are you telling me that the curse of Papa Shango had nothing to do with you losing the Intercontinental Championship?
Well, tell you what, Mr. Perfect, you believe what you want to believe, but as far as I know, the only way to get beat in the ring is by the opponent that you're wrestling against. Now, Papa Shango, here's a guy that's been running around using fear as his whole weapon. This is the basic, this is all he's got.
I think he's got your number.
Weapon.
I think you're a believer.
You think I'm a believer? Then why doesn't Papa Shango turn me into a newt or something? Why does he do that?
I thought he already did.
Wait just a moment.
Come on.
Let me ask you a very important question. Hitman. Hitman. How are relationships now between Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog's family, and your family?
Everything's pretty much smoothed over. Me and the British Bulldog decided that we're going to sort of let things lie. We want to let the family kind of patch it. Everything's back to normal.
So you mean
normal.
The families are all back together?
Yeah, we're back to normal.
So
we're
that means they're going to stiff you for some gifts this year at Christmas, huh?
Huh?
Oh, never mind. Hitman Bret Hart, it seems to me.
Sure, if you'd have blown that family off, you wouldn't have time.
Excuse me. It seems to me that what we have here is a classic example. When you meet Papa Shango, this man is huge. He's massive. We're talking brute force against the highly technical skills of the hitman, Bret Hart. Obviously, I'm sure you're confident that your wrestling skills and your ability will pull you through, are you not?
Well, you know, I could be like some ex-Intercontinental champions like you, Mr. Perfect, that just hang up the tights and all of a sudden they call themselves self-proclaimed wrestling geniuses. I'm not going to do that. I think the best thing for me to do right now is to get right back on my horse and ride, and the best guy I can do that against is Papa Shango. Exactly. I'm going to prove to everybody in the World Wrestling Federation that Papa Shango is just a big myth. He's just the big boogeyman, and the hitman is going to execute Papa Shango and his big curse.
Come on,
Papa Shango, curse me.
Thank you very much, Hitman Bret Hart. We thank you very much for joining us right now. Let's